What happened in that fight? Oh, yeah. Rematch, and how would a fight go?
They was worried about each other in the beginning. It wasn't like a Charlotte fight. Like, we got to fight. We got to get hit no matter what. We got to be clever about this, though. You're not going to hit me more than I'm going to hit you, all right? It seemed like they had agreement in this fight. Mm. The way the fight played out to me, I felt like it was going to be an aggressor and it was going to be a boxer. It wasn't like that. They seemed to be doing the opposite every time, so it made the fight like a real, I don't know. I got to go watch it again. I watch it a lot, so I kind of tell me what's going on. Like, the head movement from Canelo in the beginning was a lot slower. Canelo didn't fight the whole round. He fought half of the round. But sometimes he fought in the beginning of the round, or sometimes he fought in the end to catch up. That's the rounds he lost every time he didn't start off good. So I noticed a lot of things. I mean, look, I'm ready to fight one of them to see if I can do it. Bigger than Canelo and GGG. Y'all give me a chance, man.
What would be different if you were to fight either one?
Who?
What would be different if you were to fight either one?
What would you do, Trevor?
Everything they did.
No.
Tell us what would happen.
Ooh.
Bring it, man.
Look. First off, I give him something different. I got a jab. I want to touch you. I want to get physical. I'm with that. So this will be a way different fight. Styles make fights. I'm fast too. I'm not no slow fighter. So you got to think about it. And I don't want to get hit. I got my Mayweather shit together. So I'm ready.
Do you
what
think?
Was your first thought when you heard Danny Jacobs sign a contract with HBO?
He gone. Roadrunner.
Oh.
What do you mean?
You don't want to fight you?
It's a lot of road runners in the business. You gotta know how to keep going. You know, like, I don't care about it. They gonna be back. You feel me? Sooner I catch up, sooner or later. You know, when I catch up, though, I'll try to fight something. Give me some feed. I'm all right with it.
When somebody like Abel Sanchez says, when they hear your name, this is even before the Highland fight, when he says he's got to earn his way, he's got to earn his respect, is that code for we don't want to fight him?
It's code to say, like, it's levels to this. Basically, he just letting y'all know that there's levels to this. Jamal Charlo is nothing at 60 right now, so let it bake. He's gonna bake it up. It's gonna get to the point. If he wait too long,
are you okay with that?
If he wait too long, that's it.
How long until you start calling them duckers, though? Because it seems like you have a lot of respect for them.
Yeah.
I got a lot of respect for the game of boxing, man. I can't just, I can call them duckers all day long. That don't mean they're gonna fight me. That's gonna make them not fight me even more. So mm-hmm. I learned to be cool and keep collective until I finish fighting.
Good question.
Then when the fight over, I don't gotta worry about none of that no more. I already did what I had to do.
He talked
about one more thing.
He wasn't very good.
How many fighters get shit talked to them, get shit thrown at them, you knock their ass out and then hug them? That's an oxymoron.
Mm-hmm.
You figure it out.
When you step inside the ring, or when you prepare for your fights, do you have a particular hate against your opponents, resistance toward your personal?
Yeah, I want to take them out. I ain't gonna lie to you. I want to break them down. I want to hit them with something that they not gonna ever see and not wake up from. Like I do. I can't lie to you. Like the whole time I'm training, I train with that in my mind. Like I want to punch him with something that he won't see, won't know about, and it's gonna hurt. Like I do. I get possessive about it. I pray on it. Pray I hit him with something that he'll never see, murder intentions.
As you become more successful in your career thus far, does that need to, let's say, rip someone's head off? Does that
continue? Oh, I have to, man. This is boxing. They can rip my head off, I'm going to rip their head off. It's boxing. It's a dog-eat-dog world. Look, you don't make it in the promotional side, you're not going to make it in the boxing side. You're going to fight them, act this.
Can you talk a little bit more about the encounter with Mike Tyson when he was, because Erickson Lubin used to be his fighter, so I can kind of see.
Oh, that's what it was. Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's no big deal. You know, Mike Tyson, we love Mike Tyson. We see him a lot. My twin brother just went to embrace him. He was like, wait, which one of y'all fighting?
Okay.
Then he shook my hand. Not my brother. My brother felt like, all right, I'm going to show him, you know, but then we all took pictures and it was like nothing, but still love those guys. Bernard Hopkins showed me mass love at the beginning of my career, but I was going to fight a Philly fighter. He wasn't on my team.
If the Lara fight does happen between your brother and Lara, how do you reconcile that with yourself? Have you even thought about if that happens, how do you reconcile it?
Like I said, I'm not ready to process this Lara and my brother fighting right now. It's too much to process. I don't want it to happen right now because hey, I could possibly be needing Marfa Sparn, my trainer. I don't want to go through nothing with my trainer. If Lara go and want to fight my brother, then my trainer is against my brother. I'm not fucking with Ronnie. Just how I was born.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's my trainer of my life. It'll end right then and there because I'm not ready for it. And that's just how it is. I got to be ready for it first. And my twin brother, he's ready for it. I keep telling him no. And if he don't listen to me, he's going to draw some. Y'all might see us fight.
All right.